Hey guys, welcome to today's session. This is Shweta Roy, your English master teacher at Vedantu. And in today's session, we are going to deal with the a very, very, very interesting and amazing and a fun read as well. And the name of the chapter is A Triumph of Surgery, which is taken from your class 10 NCERT book. Okay? So let us delve into this chapter and enjoy this amazing lesson, because yes, this is about a pet. Yes, and the pet was, as you, I think you have already read the chapter, the pet's name is Tricky. So before entering into the chapter, let me ask you one question. How many of you have pets at your homes? So please don't forget to comment in the comment section. Because yes, we kind of enjoy interacting with pets. Even I have pets in my home. I have cats at my home. So I really love the time spent with them, right? So how many of you actually have pets at your home? And how many of you love to spend time with them? And what do you think are the advantages of having a pet? Please try to comment in the comment section. I would be really glad to help you out in that, right? So before entering into today's session, first of all, I would thank all of you to share your love and support. And because of that, we have become now a family of 5 lakh young minds. And we are proud to announce what about our V-Quiz, which is a live online quiz. And here you can score, learn as well as earn. So what are you waiting for? Quickly download the app and start learning, scoring and earning. So now, as I already told you that we are going to study an amazing chapter and we will really, really enjoy the fun of this lesson, because this is about a pet dog. So how many dog lovers or how many animal lovers out there? Just give me a high five in the chat box, like in the comment section, right? So so you can see when you read the title of the story, you can see that it is talking about some surgery and surgery becoming triumphant. Now, what is triumph? Triumph is triumph means victorious. So when while reading the chapter, we are surrounded with various questions like what kind of surgery is the chapter talking about, right? And what is this triumph, right? Is the triumph success? That means, is the chapter or the lesson dealing with some kind of a surgery becoming successful? So these are the various questions that keep on surrounding us when we read the title of the story, and that kind of arouses our curiosity. So when you are actually talking about the justification of the title, then in the introductory part, you need to say, you need to pinpoint this. Right, that the read while reading the chapter's title, we are immediately surrounded with a lot of questions, and these are the questions, and then you start to justify the answer, right? So let's see now this lesson. This Triumph of Surgery is a story which is written by James Alfred Wright, and actually the pen name of this author is James Herriot. And this author is also the narrator in the story, okay? And the entire story is written in first person narrative. If you read the story, you'll understand. He was a British veterinary surgeon and also a writer. And he used to, he spent many of his years as a veterinary surgeon. And he wrote a series of books which included the relationship between the animals and their owner. So he was kind of fascinated with the animal world, right? Even I am very much fascinated about the animals. I am a huge animal lover, right? So how many of you are like me? Please comment in the comment box, right? And please share your stories with your animals or with your pets. I would love to read that, because I'm a huge animal lover. And when I'll talk about the next, like I'll come up with the next session on this particular chapter, I'm going to show you some of the amazing videos of my pet, okay? Of my pet, that is, I have cats, 2 to 3 cats. So if I can get, I'll definitely show you the videos of those in our next next session on this particular chapter. And I would love to hear it out from you, like your story, with your pet animals, right? Okay, so he is best known for these semi-autobiographical works, and beginning with If Only They Could Talk. So 1970 he wrote this amazing work called If Only They Could Talk, and this led to a series of movies and television series, right? So anyways, we are kind of fascinated with the activities of animals, and we really enjoy spending time with them, looking at their activities, right? So that is why his stories were kind of crowd pulling, and it led to a series of movies and television series which went quite popular. Yes, so before moving to the session, I would again remind you to kindly download this app and have access to free live classes from the safety of your home, because we are committed to help all of you out there. And please try to follow this link in order to check out more. Now, let me introduce the story to you a little bit, and then we will read some portions from the text as well, so as to so that you can relate to the chapter very well, connect with the chapter very well. And yes, one question is important from this chapter is the humor part of the story. So you need to understand the humorous elements in the story. For that, I'm going to read out those sections which will give you an understanding of the humor, right? So this story is about Tricky, a dog who is the pet of a rich lady. So two important characters are there. One is this lady, rich lady, who's Mrs. Pumphrey, and she is the sole rich owner of this dog called Tricky. Now, Mrs. Pumphrey is a rich lady, but she is at the same time very alone, devoid of any company. So all her love, all her pampering, because she doesn't have any child, right? And she's completely alone. No, she has no one except this Tricky. So she kind of showers all her love to this Tricky, this dog. And like animals are, always asking for food. So Tricky was also very greedy, and that was his only fault, as the narrator says in the story, that the only fault that Tricky had was greed. And Mrs. Pumphrey was not very strict about that, about the diet of Tricky. She was very lenient, because she used to shower all her love to this creature, this dog. She was very lenient, and she used to pamper her dog a lot. As a result, what happened? That led to the dog becoming obese and unhealthy. Right? The story narrates how the author, Mr. Harriet, helped the dog to get back in fit. So what is the story all about? The story is all about the author, who's a veterinary surgeon, Mr. Harriet. He helped the dog in order to get back his fitness. So the dog had become obese and unhealthy because of the constant food, constant having of different kind of food items. And we will see what are the food items that she always used to give Tricky. And that led to the obesity and unhealthiness of this dog, and how he becomes ill because of this obesity, and then how ultimately he is restored to his health, he gets back his health and he gets back his fitness. That is what we are going to deal with when we are moving ahead with this chapter. So now let's see what the story has to tell you. Interested? Okay. Now the story starts when Mrs. Pumphrey, a rich lady, takes her dog out for a walk. So as we all do, like the dog owners would relate to it much better, that you need to take your dog out for a walk, right? So she was also taking her dog out for a walk, and a nearby veterinary doctor who knows the lady, he sees the dog. And when he saw the dog, he became so shocked, because the dog was very obese, looked like, a sausage, bloated sausage. So you can see the author is comparing the obese dog, bloated, like with what? With a sausage. Okay. He advises her to stop giving him unhealthy things to eat, but Mrs. Pumphrey is not able to refuse him. So as I told you, that Mrs. Pumphrey used to pamper her dog a lot, right? So her indulgence, extreme indulgence actually led this dog to become obese. And she, in spite of the doctor, you know, warning Mrs. Pumphrey again and again to maintain a strict diet and to help him to exercise, do not give him unhealthy food items in between. But she is not able to refuse him, right? Soon the dog, what happens, he falls sick and the same doctor, veterinary surgeon, is called. The narrator then somehow takes Tricky, the dog, to the hospital, even though he knows that Mrs. Pumphrey is not ready to leave her dog and nearly fainted just by hearing these words. So again, the use of humor is there. Let me read out to you the section. Okay. Let me read out that section. Okay. I tried to sound severe. So the narrator gave severe warning to Mrs. Pumphrey. Now I really mean this. If you don't cut his food right down and give him more exercise, he's going to be really ill. You must harden your heart and keep him on a very strict diet. So that is what Mrs. Pumphrey is unable to do. She is unable to harden her heart because she had no one else to pamper her, to showcase her love to. Only this dog. So she is not able to maintain, her strictness when she deals with her dog. Right? Mrs. Pumphrey says, "Oh, I will, Mr. Herriot. I'm sure you are right. But what happens ultimately is, I watched their progress with growing concern. Tricky was tottering along in his little tweed coat. He had a whole wardrobe of this coat. So, you know, these are the areas where you need to concentrate on, because these are the areas of showcasing of love towards Tricky. So how much did Mrs. Pumphrey love? That is justified in these areas. See, he had a whole wardrobe of these coats for the cold weather and a raincoat for the wet days. Again, humor. See, a dog having so many coats, more than a human would have, right? And even for rainy season, he had a separate coat, raincoat. Isn't that humorous? He struggled on, drooping in his harness. I thought it wouldn't be long before I heard from Mrs. Pumphrey. So when he saw Tricky moving like that, moving in unhealthy steps and looking so obese, he could understand. He had this, this feeling that he would immediately be called by. So he kind of foreboded that he would be now called by Mrs. Pumphrey, right? The expected call came, and as he had predicted, the call came immediately, right? Within a few days, Mrs. Pumphrey was distraught, very disturbed. Why? Tricky could eat nothing. So she had actually fed him so much, made him so obese, that ultimately he became ill and he completely lost his appetite. Refused even his favorite dishes, right? And besides, he had bouts of vomiting. So what happened? He was seriously ill. He started vomiting and he even refused to have whatever was his favorite dishes. You remember, he was a very greedy dog. Always, he was a kind of food lover. Always wanted food. But now that same dog lost his appetite, was not eating anything, right? I made my plans in advance. The only way was to get Tricky out of the house for a period. I suggested that he be hospitalized for a fortnight to be kept under observation. The poor lady almost swooned. So the narrator said that I need to keep him out of this place, because he knew that if he remains in this place, his health is going to deteriorate even more. So he was determined to remove Tricky out of this place and move him to the hospital so that he could treat him and restore his health back. So he said that you are supposed to, I'm going to take him out and to the hospital. And this very fact, as soon as he said this, Mrs. Pumphrey almost fainted, right? So that is what he says over here. Yes, she was sure he would pine and die if she did not see her every day. So that was the love shared between the bond shared between the owner and the dog. That if Miss Pumphrey thought that if he is parted away from Mrs. Pumphrey, then he would die. Why? Because he would always long for the sight of Mrs. Pumphrey, because he was completely habituated with Mrs. Pumphrey. Right. But I took a firm line. But the narrator was extremely strict about this. Tricky was very ill and this was the only way to save him. So you can see the character of the narrator as well from here. Mr. Harriet, he was a very, you know, efficient doctor as well as a good doctor, a strict one, right? And a very clever one. And how? Because he knew how to deal with Mrs. Pumphrey and how to actually treat this dog by taking him out of that place to the hospital, right? And what happened when he was actually taking away, this dog, Tricky? So, listen to this. This is very, very important from your NCERT book. Please underline these points. What happened? What was the exact scenario when the narrator came to take, Tricky away? This portion is very important. The entire staff was roused and maids rushed in and out, bringing his day bed, his night bed, favorite cushions, toys, rubber rings, breakfast bowl, lunch bowl, supper bowl. So these are again the areas where the author is introducing humor, right? So breakfast bowl, lunch bowl, supper bowl, everything was brought, right? Realizing that my car would never hold all the stuff. So his car was not huge enough to hold a load of a host of stuff which belonged to whom? Belonged to a dog. Was he in need of all these things? So this is the area where actually the author is creating humor. I started to drive away. So he realized that his car is not going to hold all these things. So what did he do? He drove away. Without, taking all these. As I moved off, Mrs. Pumphrey with a despairing cry. So just imagine the situation, Pumphrey shouting. Because she needs to, give all these things, all these belongings of Tricky to the hospital. Because she thinks that Pumphrey would not be able to survive. Pumphrey was very, very, very pampered. This is how we come to know that to what extent Pumphrey was pampered. And this also brings about the humor of the story. So kindly underline these words and write humor so that while framing your answer, it will be helpful for you. Right? So as I moved off, Mrs. Pumphrey threw an armful of little coats through the window. So she started throwing the coats that belonged to, the dog, Tricky. Why? Because she wanted that to reach the hospital. Right? I looked in the mirror before I turned the corner of the drive. Everybody was in tears. So everyone started crying because that Tricky, he was the ladla of the house. Hai na? He was the only one, the most lovable creature in the house. The most lovable in the house was Tricky. So jaise ghar ka ladla bichhad jata hai, to sab rone lagte hai. Similarly, when Tricky started to part away, everyone started crying. And Mrs. Pumphrey started throwing away all his coats and they brought all the belongings that belonged to Tricky and they wanted this narrator to take him to the hospital. And the way the narrator managed the situation again contributes to the humor of the story. So kindly locate the humorous element with me, right? On the road, I glanced down at the pathetic little animal gasping on the seat by my side. So now he takes the dog along and he puts, he takes the dog and by his side. And what he sees is the dog is gasping. He's not unable to breathe. He has become so obese that he is also becoming breathless, right? I patted the head and Tricky made a brave effort to wag his tail. poor old lad, I said. So he could very well understand the condition, the situation of, this dog, Tricky. So Mrs. Pumphrey, actually, she thought that by giving all these food items to Tricky, she would make him healthy. But the ironic part of the story is that, of this point is, the irony in this is that her giving up extra love, extra pamper, extra food made the dog unhealthy and obese to the point that he needed to be shifted to the hospital. So that is quite ironical, right? And he was unable to even respond to anything because dogs are extremely playful. If you pat your dog on the head or if you just touch your touch the head of the dog, you will see that the dog, he responds quickly. Instantly they respond, right? But this dog, as he was completely he had absolutely no energy. So he became completely listless. So therefore, he could not even respond with energy. And his wagging of the tail seemed like a brave effort. Right. So that is very important. Now, when he takes the dog to his surgery. Now, what is this surgery? Surgery is actually the hospital. Right. So the hospital is, the hospital is the term for surgery over here, like surgery as in not the actual process of surgery, but the hospital. Okay, so he takes the dog along and he puts a bed for him in his surgery. The dog doesn't move, nor he eats anything for the first 2 days. On the second day, he starts to look around and he whimpers, makes a soft sound. Okay, so for 2 days, he does not even move. He was so ill. And third, on the second day, what happened? He starts to look around the hospital, the surgery, and he started making small sounds. He wanted to go out on the third day and started playing with the dogs. Now, let me tell you what happened. Right. For 2 days, I kept an eye on him, giving him no food. So, since 2 days, he was having absolutely no food, but only water. So, he kept the dog on a water diet, right? And for 2 days, yes. And the end of the second day, he started to show some interest. And then he began, on the third day, what happened? He began to, whimper, make soft sounds when he started to hear the other dogs playing outside. When I opened the door, Tricky trotted out and was immediately engulfed by Joe, the greyhound. So, there was a greyhound in the surgery, in the hospital, named Joe. Okay. And when the narrator opened the door, what happened to Tricky? Tricky immediately moved out. Right. And he was engulfed by Joe immediately. And also his friends. After rolling him over and thoroughly inspecting him, the dogs moved off down the garden. Tricky followed them, rolling slightly with his surplus fat, right? So now he started to play with the other dogs, okay? So as he became a little better, but he was still having that extra fat in him, surplus as in extra, okay? So he started a little bit slowly. We can see that Tricky's health is restoring. He's making a good progress, okay? Next, when they had finished, Tricky took a walk round the shining bowls, licking casually inside one or two of them. Now he started to go to his bowl. Remember, he had completely lost his appetite, was not eating anything. So now when his condition started improving, he went and he started to lick the bowls, right? Casually. Next day, an extra bowl was put out for him. So initially, those bowls were for other dogs. And when the narrator saw that now Tricky is improving, he is, started to lick the bowls of the other dog. So he put an extra bowl for him. Okay. And next day, what happened? I was pleased to see him jostling his way towards it. So he started to push everyone, jostle everyone, and find his way towards that bowl, the extra bowl that the narrator had kept for Tricky. So that was a pleasant sight for narrator. From then on, his progress was rapid. So now his condition started to improve rapidly, and he started even fighting for his meals with other dogs, right? So he had no medical treatment of any kind, but all day he ran about with the dogs, joining in their friendly scrimmages. He discovered the joys of being bowled over, tramped on, and squashed every few minutes. He became an accepted member of the gang, an unlikely, silky little object among the shaggy crew, fighting like tiger for his share at meal times and hunting rats in the old house at old hen house at night. He had never had such a time in his life. This entire paragraph is important, so kindly mark this entire paragraph and write beside it that Tricky's condition in the, like, how did Tricky enjoy in the hospital? So this is how he used to enjoy in the hospital, always, you know, he had actually not undergone any medical surgery. He was not given any artificial treatment, but the doctor, the surgeon, he treated him so well naturally. He used to play with the other dogs and he used to fight for food like a tiger, and then he used to catch rats in the hen house at night. And he found pleasure in being, you know, being jumped over, being like, he played with the other dogs, had fun, extreme pleasure. So that is how he enjoyed his time during his stay in the hospital. And this can come as your question in the exam. So kindly mark this paragraph, right? Very important paragraph. When this news reached Mrs. Pumphrey, she started sending him eggs. So again, she started. So this is another humorous element. So Mrs. Pumphrey will never improve, right? So again, when she understood that now Tricky is recovering, so again she started showing her extra pampering and started sending him eggs. Started to overfeed again. She started sending him eggs as she thought that Tricky was recovering from an illness and needed energy food, right? So you can easily relate. Mrs. Pumphrey's situation with some of the parents in the modern family. Many parents, they do what? They try to pamper their child so much nowadays that actually, instead of doing good, they cause harm to the child. Just like Mrs. Pumphrey is doing. Mrs. Pumphrey's child was Tricky, right? So Tricky was like just like a child to him, to her. So now when she started understanding that Tricky is recovering, and she thought that now he needs energy. So in order to get him energetic, what did she do? She started sending eggs. This is what most of the parents also do, right? Mr. Harriet and his partner started eating those eggs for morning breakfast. So herein again comes the humorous part. I'll read out that chapter, like that portion. Yes, she started to bring round fresh eggs, 2 dozens at a time, to build up Tricky's strength. For a happy period, my partners and I had 2 eggs each for a breakfast. Very, very, very important. Humorous element. So now, the narrator do? Obviously, that those eggs could not be given to Tricky because again, it would hamper his health. He had just now recovered from his unhealthy condition, right? So now, the hospital staff started enjoying the meal, the eggs, the extra, food that was sent in the name of Tricky. Right. When the bottles of wine began to arrive, so she did not stop till eggs. Now she started to send even wine. So look at Mrs. Pumphrey's condition. Right. The real possibilities of the situation began to dawn on the household. It was to enrich Tricky's blood. So she started sending wine in order to enrich Tricky's blood. So just imagine, right? So again, humor. Okay. Lunch became a ceremonial occasion with 2 glasses of wine before and several during the meal. So who is enjoying these wine bottles, these eggs sent by Mrs. Pumphrey? The hospital staff along with the narrator. And he says, for us, we did not have simple lunch, but we had party. What was that party? What was the ceremony? Because of the glasses of wine. So we started enjoying the wine that was sent by Mrs. Pumphrey. Two glasses before and several during. So just imagine, they had a great time, right? And all and the responsible person was Tricky. Because of Tricky, they were being able to enjoy. Okay, so entire paragraph, please underline and write over there humor. Okay, we could hardly believe it when the brandy came to put a final edge on Tricky's constitution. So now, not only she stopped at wine, but now she also gave brandy. Okay, so now brandy was also there again, humor. For a few nights, the fine spirit was rolled around, inhaled, and reverently drunk. So no matter, they did not stop at wine and egg also. Now brandy also came, and they enjoyed brandy as well, like anything. They were days of deep content, starting well with extra egg in the morning. So now this became a daily routine. They started with extra egg in the morning, improved and sustained by the midday wine. So their meal was improved. How? By the wine that Mrs. Pumphrey sent. So their standard came to a rise by the addition of wine in their meal, right? So sustained, it was continuous by the midday wine and finishing luxuriously round the fire with the brandy. So started with the morning eggs. During the lunch, they used to have wine, and then at the end of the day ended with brandy. So they were having a gala time, enjoying the food items of Tricky, which his owner used to send for him. It was a temptation to keep Tricky on as a permanent guest. So they enjoyed to such an extent that they felt that we should keep Tricky permanently as our guest. So that there is a continuous supply of all these items in our place. So in your question, in your exam, this can be asked that why did the author want to keep Tricky? Like, why was he tempted to keep Tricky as a permanent guest? But I knew Mrs. Pumphrey was suffering, and after a fortnight felt compelled to phone. So he had no other option, because he understood that I should not do this, because Mrs. Pumphrey, she must be suffering, right? So he made a wise decision and he called up Mrs. Pumphrey, as she was really, really worried. And on this side, Tricky was ready to be taken home. So she informed Mrs. Pumphrey about the restoration of the health of Tricky, and now Mrs. Pumphrey, she was overjoyed to hear this news, and now it was time for Tricky to be back home. Now the last portion is again very important. Very, very important is, yes, I walked through the house into the garden. A mass of dogs was hurtling round the lawn in their midst, ears flapping, tail wagging, was the little golden figure of Tricky. So when the narrator went to fetch Tricky, he was playing with the other dog. So he was also enjoying his time in the hospital, right? Hard muscled, okay, in 2 weeks. So what was the transformation of Tricky? That is again important. So please underline this. In 2 weeks, he had been transformed to a lean, hard-muscled animal. He was keeping up well with the pack, stretching out in great bounds, his chest almost brushing the ground. So he had become completely healthy, hard-muscled, light animal. He had become very bulky, right? So this is the transformation that he had after, this successful surgery, quote-unquote surgery, which was not actually a surgery, but yes, he treated him naturally, by giving him water diet and by making him play with the other dogs constantly, and finally restoring his health. And now he was completely fit, hard muscled animal, and he really enjoyed his stay at the hospital that we have already seen, right? So now, yes, again he mingled very easily with the other dogs, though he was kind of silky. He had this he was a well-bred dog, right? And Mrs. Pumphrey pampered him a lot, but still he had no problem in mingling with the other dogs who were unkempt and who were shabby, who were not so well bred like Tricky. But that was not something which inhibited him from joining the other dogs and playing with them, right? And then when he came to fetch Tricky, he carried him back along the passage to the front door. The chauffeur was still looking the car, still holding the car door open. So chauffeur is a driver who was still holding the car door open. And when Tricky saw his mistress, the last point is very important. Tricky seeing his mistress. So what kind of bond did Tricky and his mistress share? That is very important, and that is seen in the last portion. Okay. Yes. Tricky saw his mistress, he took off from my arm. So as soon as he saw his mistress, immediately he, went back to his mistress. He jumped from the arms of the narrator and in a tremendous leap and sailed into Mrs. Pumphrey's lap. So he jumped from his, from the narrator's arms, shoulders to his mistress's lap. So that, that justifies, that shows what kind of bond Mrs. Pumphrey and Tricky shared, and how much the dog also loved his mistress. She gave a startled oh, and then had to defend herself as he swarmed over her, licking her face and barking. So imagine the situation: Tricky jumping over the mistress and starting to lick her face, and starting to bark as well, barking as in lovingly, okay? So swarmed over her and he started to also lick her face, right? I hope many of you could well imagine, right? And you could also relate to your own dog who starts to, like, dogs have this habit of showing their affection by licking the face or licking the arms, right? Even my cats also lick my hands and fingers sometimes, right? So that is their way of showing affection, okay? But the dogs usually do it. During the excitement, I helped the chauffeur to bring out the beds, toys, cushions, coats, bowls, none of which had been used. So many items Mrs. Pumphrey had sent, but none of them had been used. Obviously, that was a hospital, right? So where would he use all these? And as the car moved away, Mrs. Pumphrey leaned out of the window. Tears shone in her eyes, her lips trembled. So again, this justifies Mrs. Pumphrey's love for her Tricky, for her dog Tricky, because tears were falling. And why was her eyes shining with tears or filled with tears? Because she had not expected that Tricky would, recover so fast. And so she was very thankful for the, to the narrator for the speedy recovery of Tricky, her only dog, right? And her loved one. Oh, Mrs. Harriet, she cried, how can I ever thank you? This is a triumph of surgery. So again, the title, Triumph of Surgery. So basically, when you are asked to justify the title, I told you about the introduction, how you are going to give the introduction. And then you have to give the entire detail of how Tricky was restored back to his health by the narrator. So, you can have this question in two ways. One is, how did the narrator, treat Tricky? Or justification of the title? Your answer will basically be, the body of the answer will be absolutely the same thing, same. But only thing is that you need to mold the introduction part, the introductory part, and the conclusion. I hope you have been able to understand, right? So now Tricky was ultimately cured, and we are happy to see the healthy Tricky. So in this this entire story, one thing is important, that is the relationship between Tricky and his owner, which is also which can be similar to, or which can be looked on as the relation, deeper relationship between the parents and the children. So what is the similarity? The similarity is, in modern days, what happens, the parents also try to pamper their child so much, just as Mrs. Pumphrey, thinking that their child would be in a better condition because of their pampering, but actually this leads to a greater harm. Okay, so how many of you agree with this view? Please post your comments that what do you think about the parents who over pamper their child. Do you think that this would enable the child to learn good values of life, or would they, you know, would it be a harm to their upbringing? So extra pampering, according to my opinion, extra pampering always leads to harm in the upbringing, right? So I would love to see your comments in the comment section, and thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and you could also relate to your own pets. And stay tuned for the next session, wherein I'll discuss some of the major important question answers along with the important themes. And of course, the humor, I'll jot down all the humorous parts so that you could refer to that, those areas when you look back in the text, and that would be helpful to frame your answers. And yes, I will also try to show some of the videos related to the pet that I have, and you could also post your comments about, relating your story, your own pet story. So I'm waiting for your comments. So thank you so much for watching. So stay well, stay safe.